Presents a big strike zone.
And now, are the people not...
Speedster Enrique Blackfield Jr. at the plate. Corners have to play in. If you have to watch the drag here. Second baseman playing deep and up the middle at second.
Enrique Blackfield, the leadoff hitter. Two singles tonight. Next throw, pitch 38. Stanford made has heard of the walk issued by Brendan Beck to Javier Faz. After what the work Beck has left in the tank, he's been so good, and it's Carter Young with a chance to win it for Vanderbilt.
Beck sits down the first 80 faces, punched out 5 of the 8 with a 2-out walk. Backside ground ball.
Jones at third base. The Pac-12 Pitcher of the Year by Minka.
who was so good for the first eight guys. And you go two on walk, a couple singles, and we saw this with the breaking ball. This hits you. It's late at night, and if your hands get a little bit slick, that's what you're going to get sometimes with that curveball. He did it earlier in this inning where it wasn't quite that high. This one just squirts out of his hand. Nothing Cody Huff could do, and two outs, nobody on. It looked like this ball game was over. Sure, Vanderbilt's still on.
It just goes to show you how many ways you can score from third base.
Yeah.
Again, 90 feet makes a difference in this. The improbable has just happened here. That was, again, the two outs. I did not think that Vanderbilt had a chance to win the fastest pitch. This is a heartbreaker.
You feel terrible for Stanford, and in particular, Brandon Benn, who came out of the bullpen and was lights out. Pilot said, as good as you've ever seen him, from a 96 miles an hour. And it's Vanderbilt keeping the dream alive of going back-to-back.